topics. Today's topic here at Didgeridoo Breath, Fremantle, Australia, the world, in somewhere in the cosmos, is the hemp didgeridoo. So basically, I know a little bit about how these are made, so I'll just give you a short run through. Basically, hemp didgeridoo, as it sounds like, is made from hemp, and it's made from an industrial form of hemp, which is ground up very fine in a big mill, like a paper mill, and then mixed with water, and then it becomes a kind of sludge, and then the sludge is sprayed onto a mold which is made of it's like a sandbag, and it comes out of a gun, so it gets sprayed onto this long mold, which is basically the mold gives you the internal shape of the instrument, and then it comes out very wet, very fat. It looks a bit like an elephant's leg, like it literally is like this. You just can't believe it's a didgeridoo. Then it goes into a drying room where it is very hot, of course. It's like a sort of low temperature oven, and it's baked for a few days, and all of the moisture leaves the hemp, and the hemp shrinks onto the sandbag and creates the hemp didgeridoo, just like this. Now it's basically been something that was invented by an Austrian man called Martin. I've forgotten his surname right now, but his name is Martin. And these didgeridoos are designed by John. And John has been my didgeridoo maker since about 17 years. And we worked together a lot over the years on finding the ultimate shapes of didgeridoos. And in the last few years, he's just completely gone off on his own tangents and really found some incredible shapes. So this is what it is. It's a hemp didgeridoo. It's phenomenally authentic, natural product, and when the fibre dries, basically in the drying room, what happens is the molecules that have been separated through the grinding process, they all rebond together. So that's basically cellulose fibres, and those cellulose fibres re-knit, and it forms one single piece of cellulose fibre. So it's basically like a wood-like structure, except that it's extremely durable, very, very hard, and it's far less receptive or far less sensitive to heat. Like, you can leave it in a hot car, you can put it in the hold of an aeroplane, you can do all those things, and it doesn't degrade, or it doesn't break or snap or crack. They're just basically really strong, so they sound good. So, without further ado,